presence we see, even among we pastors, easily get angry. What can you say about this?
Well, that's a fact which nobody can deny. But all one will say to those group of people, pastors and members alike, is that we need to go back to the origin, go back to the altar, lay our life upon the altar, ask God to deal with our life, that weak aspect of us.
Look at Genesis chapter 34. And I read from verse 20. I'm going to be very fast because of our time. And Ammon and Shechem, his son, came unto the gate of their city and communed with the men of their city, saying, these men are peaceable with us. Therefore, let them dwell in the land and trade therein, for the land, behold, it is large enough for them. Let us take their daughters to us for wives, and let us give them our daughters. Only herein will the men consent unto us, for to dwell with us, to be one people, if every man among us is circumcised as they are circumcised. Shall not their cattle and their substance, and every beast of theirs be ours? Only let us consent unto them, and then we will dwell with us. They will dwell with us. And unto Hamor and unto Shechem, his son, Achim, all that went out of the gate of the city, and every male was circumcised. All that went out of the gate of the same city. And then look at verse 25. And it came to pass on the third day, when they were sore, I think the sore was still there, the two of the sons of Jacob, Simon and Levi, Dinah's brethren, took each man a sword and came upon the city boldly and slew all the males. And they slew Ammon and Shechem, his son, with the edge of the sword, and took Dinah out of Shechem's house and went out. Then look at Genesis chapter 49. Look at verse 5. Simon and Levi are eight brethren. Instruments of cruelty are in their habitation. Oh, my soul, come not down into their secret. Unto the assembly, my honor, be not thou united. For in their anger, they slew a man, and in their self-will, they did down a wall. Cursed be their anger, for it was fierce, and their wrath, for it was cruel. I will divide them in Jacob and scatter them in Israel. You know, as later in life, look at the book of, let's go back to the book of Numbers chapter 20. I'm trying to draw a kind of, I want us to go to the memory lane so that we'll be able to understand what we need to do concerning pastors, you know, getting easily angry. And Numbers chapter 20, let's start from verse, verse 6. And Moses and Aaron went from the presence of the assembly unto the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, and they fell upon their faces, and the glory of the Lord appeared unto them. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, take the rod, and gather down the assembly together, thou and Aaron thy brother, and speak ye unto the Lord before their eyes. Speak is different from smiting. And then it shall give forth his water, and thou shalt bring forth to them water out of the rock. So thou shalt give the congregation and the priest drink. And Moses took the rod from before the Lord, as he commanded in the book of verse 10. And Moses and Aaron gathered the congregation together before the Lord, and he said unto them, hear now, ye rebels, must we fetch water? Must we fetch you water out of this rock? And Moses lifted up his hand, and with his rod he smote the rock twice, and the water came out abundantly, and the congregation drank, and their peace also. And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron, because you believe me not to sanctify me the eyes of the congregation of the children of Israel. Therefore, ye shall not bring this congregation into the land which I have given yet. Now, why did I go to Genesis chapter 34, Genesis chapter 49, then Numbers chapter 14, Numbers chapter 20, from verse 16, where we just finished? Now, the reason is this, you know, Moses' problem translocated, originated from his father, his great-great-grandfather, Simon and Levi, and he was from the house of Levi. The two of them, from what Shechem did to them, to their sister Dinah, had an affair with their sister, and they deceived those people into believing that they have accepted them by asking them to be circumcised, just like they were circumcised, because they cannot give their children, I mean, they could not give their sisters to uncircumcised people. I mean, to uncircumcised people, and then eventually, those people accepted. And when they knew that they were least defensive, they killed every man. And when Jacob heard it, fear gripped him. And Jacob said, what did you do? They were few in number, considering the number of these people. So if they should come upon us, then we're gone. But all one will say to us, those group of people, pastors and members alike, is that we need to go back to the origin, go back to the altar, lay our life upon the altar, ask God to deal with our life, that weak aspect of us. When we are able to pinpoint where the areas in which we are very, very weak, whether weak, small, big weakness or small weakness, subject them to the submit them at the will of God. And let's pray. And if need be, avoid pride. Go for where prayer session is going on as a minister of God for deliverance. After I've seen a minister of God who told me I'm alive that time in a prayer session that he goes, even he himself as a deliverance minister for deliverance from the Lord. To keep himself fresh. Moses inherited it from his father Amram. Don't forget, it's a cycle of flowing all through. And where we need to understand the nature of Moses was in the earlier part of Exodus chapter 2, where he killed a man and buried a man. Why? Because the man, somebody was trying to fight against the chief, one of the children of Israel, and he killed the man. The second one, they saw two Hebrew fighters, said, we are brethren, and then the one of them said, going to kill me like you. Then they got to know that this was a public knowledge, so he took to his head. He didn't deal with that anger, even when he started his ministry. So that's why in ministry, before one is well known, deal with yourself first.
Deal with yourself first.
So when I'm very tough and rough, if you are dealing with yourself with kid gloves, you will need to be there. But you want to not pamper himself as a child of God. We have listened to our fathers in the law, people like Baba Deboye, Baba Kumuye, Dr. Lukoya, and I believe some other people that didn't say their own power, that they discovered their own personal weaknesses. And what they did, what did they do? They went to God in prayer and do it seriously. Because if we do not deal with that aspect of us, one might be a carryover to the ministry. And the Bible says, a minister of the gospel must be gentle, meek towards everybody. So if you are not gentle in the course of doing the work of the ministry, you are showing anger and annoyance, you are finished. So that's why we must deal with our background, our personal self.